Should Wilson be the highest paid quarterback, higher than your boy Aaron Rodgers, highest paid quarterback in the NFL?
He should be paid more than Aaron Rodgers, even though he's not better. He's produced more because he's been to two Super Bowls instead of one, and he's got just as many Super Bowl championships as Aaron Rodgers, and he's asked to carry as much of a load as Aaron Rodgers is asked to carry in Green Bay. But he should not be paid more than Tom Brady. I think that Tom Brady should be paid to be the highest paid quarterback in the National Football League, and I don't think anybody can dispute that.
Time out. I got to dispute that. He doesn't want to be the highest paid quarterback in the league. That's why he's got a team around him.
Excuse me. You did not ask me what Tom Brady wants. You asked me what I think.
Yeah.
And I'm telling you what I think.
But then he couldn't win Super Bowls.
Wait a minute. You asked me what I think. Okay. And I'm saying to you, I don't give a damn what Tom Brady wants. Mm-hmm. He's going to agree to what he's going to agree to. But I believe in excellence being rewarded. Mm-hmm. And when you consider the fact that this is a six-time Super Bowl champion, a multiple league MVP, mm-hmm. when you think about what Tom Brady brings to the table, I am one of those guys, and don't get me wrong, I understand the world that we're living in, fellas, but I am one of those guys. I'm very, very big on resumes. I'm very big on that. And when you have a resume that is unmatched by any of your peers.
But he wouldn't have those Super Bowls if he got paid the highest in the NFL. That's the whole point. He takes pay cuts. That's how they get players around him. They build the roster.
You could say that.
That's their success.
You could say that and we could all believe it. But you can't then turn around and call Max Kellerman the hater because he questions the cliff about Tom Brady. You got to make up your mind, Molly. The fact of the matter is that Tom Brady is universally recognized by everybody, including you, as being arguably the greatest who has ever lived. He's still playing. He's standing here now as the reigning Super Bowl champion. Yeah. He's been to the last two Super Bowls. I am sorry. I have not seen Russell Westbrook in a Super Bowl. Russell Wilson. At a Super Bowl in years. I'm of the mindset that, again, I'm happy for Russell Wilson. He deserves the money. Don't get me wrong. But when we ask the question about who should be the highest paid player, I think the highest producers should ultimately be paid. And Tom Brady's resume is incomparable right now.
Of course. And I'm just saying they're the highest producers because they take the pay cut so they can get the players around them.
Pay cut, although you also get extensions like Tom Brady. And whenever you see a quarterback redoing his deal, they're getting more guaranteed money. That includes everybody.
Whatever they're doing, it's working.
It is. And I think Belichick may be the guy who's figured out that the system of paying the next quarterback up the most money is broken. And of course, Belichick would be a step ahead. However, Russell Wilson deserves to be the highest paid player, even if Tom Brady were not on the Patriots. Russell Wilson clearly deserves more than Tom Brady because he has longer horizons in front of him, and that's how this works. Your guaranteed money is based on how good they think you are, that you get paid per year, you know, times how many more years they believe you're going to be productive. Russell Wilson's in his prime now. He has years ahead of him, one would think, of being a very productive quarterback. So he's the next guy up. He's elite. You want to call him top five? I think he's around top five. He's a winner. He's succeeded and thrived, and even when there's been nothing around him, no offensive line, no running game, where are his receivers? Still among the best. Has his team in the playoffs just about every year. Has won a Super Bowl. Came this close to winning two Super Bowls. He's the next guy up. He gets the money. Who would you rather have than Russell Wilson in the NFL, factor age in? Mm-hmm. Even of all the young guys ascending, would you take Carson Wentz over Russell Wilson? I wouldn't. He's been injury prone. Mm-hmm. Would you take Jared Goff? I wouldn't. I don't trust him under pressure from what I've seen so far. I would take Patrick Mahomes. Would you take Andrew Luck? They're contemporaries, but at this moment, I wouldn't. At this moment,
Dan,
I wouldn't.
Dan says yes.
I love Andrew Luck. He's my guy, but Dan, I just saw him choke in the playoffs. Russell Wilson's won a Super Bowl.
Come on. I'd take Andrew Luck. Listen. When factoring or asking the question of, like, should Russell be paid the highest, you have to go, if we pay Russell X, if we make him the highest paid player, can he overcome the four or five other guys that we're not going to have because of that? Like, is he good enough? Has he proven to be good enough? And do we believe he'll continue to be good enough to overcome those four or five other guys? Look at it strictly off of the reality of the situation. Since he's come into the NFL in the 7 years he's been there, he's had the worst offensive line in the NFL when it comes to pass blocking. He's been under the most pressure out of any quarterback in the NFL out of the last 7 years. So has he overcome that? They've won 10 games every year he's been there but one, and he won 9. So then you have to look at it a little bit deeper. All right, since he's coming to the NFL, who in the NFC has won more games than Russell Wilson? Nobody. since he's come to the NFL. He's won 83 games since he got drafted. So there you go. Okay, is this guy able to overcome all those other things if we pay him? Not only has he proven that, but he's given you the reality of expecting that, expecting him to continue to do that. Who's led the NFL in touchdowns over the last 2 years? Russell Wilson. I asked this a couple weeks ago on Twitter. Max, your question. Factoring in age and the reality of everybody's situation, I would take two guys. I would take Patrick Mahomes, and I would take Andrew Luck as the only guys at the quarterback spot definitively well, over Russell Wilson.
Let me tell you what's annoying me about, and I hope I'm not misconstruing your point, but what's annoying me about you and Max with this particular subject, I'm not talking long term. Y'all are looking at the $140 million. I'm looking at the $35 million per. So in other words, let's say, for example, Tom Brady right now had a one-year deal for $40 million.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You see what I'm saying? I'm not looking at the $140
million. If you're talking about average annual value.
That's all I'm talking about. I'm not talking about, oh, my goodness, Russell Wilson. Clearly, we don't believe Tom Brady's going to be playing for the next 4 years. So I'm not trying to say that Tom Brady should have a four-year, $150 million deal. I'm saying if Russell Wilson is averaging $35 million a year, Tom Brady should be at 36.
Okay, if you're talking
that,
Stephen A.
That's what I'm talking about.
If you're talking about average, then Russell Wilson's like top five. But you have to factor youth and durability and all those things in.
Do I have to? No, hold on.
Yeah, that's how it works.
Question.
Stephen A., who's done more with less?
Hold on, question. Do I have to average that in, fellas, with the average annual? That's all I'm saying.
Yes, because that the average annual is really, what you're really looking at is the guaranteed money, and that's based on the number of years they think going forward.
I know that.
That's going to jack everything up.